a server self-backup. We had a lot of partners ask us about the best way to back up the Comet server itself, which is a great reaction for a service provider to have. You know, how do I back up this? How do I back up that? Great reflex, great thing to want to do. There's a lot happening in the Comet server, all the configuration, all the user settings, policy options, before and after command settings, job history. That's all pretty important configuration. You don't want to lose it in a disaster situation. That's a great question, and we had a lot of different answers to this question, not all of them good. So you can use replication, but replication is about live failover. It's not going to protect against, you know, because it's always syncing, it's not going to protect against accidental deletions. You know, that changes that you don't want will just get synced over as well. And it requires a whole extra Comet server. You know, if all you want is just this sort of fail-safe copy of the keys, it's not quite the right answer. You can just copy Comet server's config and DB files. Since Comet server might be currently writing to those files, you only have crash consistency. The database format that Comet server uses has some journaling internally so that it won't get corrupted if you do this, but you're not necessarily going to get a good copy every time. You can retry the copy. Maybe that will work if you retry enough times. You can stop the Comet server, and then you'll definitely get a clean copy. And in fact, stopping the Comet server is actually okay because the Comet backup, like running backups, will continue through a server restart in Comet. That's one of our features. But you know, it's a pretty annoying solution just to have to restart the Comet server just to back up these files. And even more annoying than that is you can't use Comet Backup to back up the Comet server because Comet Backup requires a connection to be logged into the server as a user account. And in a disaster situation, that's all gone. So we've lost, you know, Comet Backup's features, all the chunking, retention, scheduler, encryption, cloud storage support. You can make it work. You can set it all up with some third-party apps, schedule it with Windows Task Scheduler or cron or something. But you know, if a new version of Comet Server comes out and it moves all the files around, it just shouldn't be this hard. And so we came up with a better solution. Self-backup is a built-in feature in Comet Server. It covers all the interesting and important files that Comet Server uses. You just set it up in the setup wizard, and it supports all of Comet's cloud storage options. So Amazon, Backblaze, Wasabi, FTP, and more. All the schedule settings, hourly, weekly, everything like that. All the retention settings, encryption as well. So it's very fully featured and easy to use. One thing to note is that the self-backup feature doesn't use chunking. Because the full backup system requires a connection to the running server and all that, here we're just using zip files. And so every self-backup that runs, you see here I've got it scheduled at 4 a.m. and 6 p.m. Every self-backup that runs just creates a zip file. The zip files are encrypted, passworded, and then just put on cloud storage. And then recovery is just a really simple, low-stress process. Open up the zip file and copy the files back into the Comet server folder. Voila, you've recovered from a backup. So it's just a really simple, easy system for backing up the Comet server itself, set and forget, and hopefully you'll never need it, but it's easy when you do.